Hello, crafters. This is Suzanne from A Creative Muse. And if you can tell by the smile in my voice, I am still loving all these collections in April. So much crafty goodness. Now it's time for me to introduce you to the Seahorse Kisses collection. Can you say marine life love? Yes, so pretty. All sorts of underwater tropical goodness with this collection. Love, love, love. This collection is designed by Dawn W. I'm going to put her name here on the screen because I cannot pronounce that. Dawn collaborated with Spellbinders to create this amazing Seahorse Kisses collection. So far in the April collections, we have Stylish Ovals, Seahorse Kisses, BB's Hummingbird. Are you seeing a lot of variety in this release for April? It's nature, beauty, fun, florals, animals. I mean, like, you have the seahorse, you have birds, you have hummingbirds, you've got beautiful florals. So pretty. And just so you know, the Seahorse Kisses collection is a more glimmer heavy collection. So if you have your glimmer hot foil machine and you're still waiting for the moment to be like getting over the hump of should I use it, this collection might be the all right, I'm going to just go ahead and learn to use it, make a few mistakes, but I'll get it going. Also, here's a little sidebar, and it's a glimmer sidebar. Because Spellbinders has realized that a lot of crafters have bought the glimmer hot foil system, that's the machine. I bought mine and it did park for like a month or two before I was like, okay, I just have to use it. Some people have bought the machine and it's been like a year brand new in the box. They're coming out with a workshop. I believe it's in May. If I can find a graphic, I'm going to put it here for that step-by-step workshop. Reason why you may want to do that one, you could do the workshop. It's an online workshop. Take out your Platinum 6 die cut machine or whichever wide platform machine, meaning it has to have a wide opening like a Sizzix Big Shot. We Are Memory Keepers Evolution, that style, wider opening, not the slim opening, but a wider opening. And you could have your machine ready, your glimmer hot foil machine ready, and glimmer along with the video. So it's going to be a true, slow, step-by-step process. You might want to take a look into that if you really want to get a good grip of how to do glimmering, because it is absolutely worth it. Do I need to say more? This collection might be the one that pushes you into the, okay, it's time. Everybody's been talking about it. It's now time. Yeah, this one is like super pretty. So here are my two card examples. And if you notice too, they're pretty, I don't want to say simple, but they're very clean cards, which usually I don't do like crazy clean cards, especially this one. This one is like uber clean, but am I loving it? This is like glimmer goodness, 100%, no other frills to it. Just created a frame and everything else is glimmered. These two are popped up, some little dots and done. A recipient would love to get something like this. Super elegant, right? A little bit oversized from an A2 because I wanted to enjoy my collage of glimmer goodness. True A2. All right, let's now go into, and I'll bring these back in, but let's go into the products. Let's get started. Here is the Seahorse Kisses collection. You get three sets of glimmer hot foil plates. We have sentiments, sea life, seahorse collage with sentiments. Gorgeous, 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 gorgeous. If this is speaking to you, and you're going to see more examples from me, this one is really, really beautiful. There is also a stamp set, Seahorse Garden Stamps. There are not any coordinating dies for this one, okay? It's just the stamp set where you get the seahorse, little sea life. Look at that sentiment. Our friendship is deeper than the ocean. This will stamp like a dream. Super duper duper pretty. And there is a 3D embossing folder. You know I love a good 3D embossing folder. This is one of them. Look at that net on this scale. Oh, look at all the little knots in the net. Let's take it out. It's called Castaway. Didn't get a chance to play with Castaway yet. It's coming. Come on, can we say ooh la la? Castaway must add to your stash, especially if you love your cruising or boating. This might be the one that's like, all right, it's time. You have a bunch of friends that you go on cruises with, or you guys go boating together, fishing. Your husband, he loves his fishing and all this stuff. Or you guys have a timeshare in the Bahamas. Wouldn't that be nice? Wish I did. This could definitely fit all those cards. Any occasion. I live here in South Florida. So for me, this is just a easy South Florida thing in terms of right here. I'm looking at Key West, Bahamas, Jamaica. This is all good right here. Hawaii too. Oh yes. Love, 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 love. Castaway, oversized 3D embossing folder. 5.5 inch wide, 8.5 inch tall. Use your universal plate system. Seahorse garden stamps. I'm bringing it back. Color this up. You could do delicate watercoloring with this one. Super pretty. Or use your alcohol inks. Spellbinders does carry sets of Olo markers. I will put a link for it. And I store my Olo markers in this little box that I got at Hobby Lobby. Somebody had asked me once, so I'm always showing you guys. It's like a long Hobby Lobby iris box. Okay? Super cute for storing rulers and markers and all the goodies. First up, this is called Seahorse Kisses Sentiments Glimmer Hot Foil Plates. You get the coordinating die to cut around the sentiments. Here you're seeing an example of all three done in different colorways. When you're seeing this gold colorway, you're looking at the Satin Metallics 4-pack. You're also looking here at the opaque black and white. This is white hammer mill cardstock with the opaque black hot foil roll. Here you're looking at, oh gosh, I can't remember the name, because there is more than one shade of purple at Spellbinders. I'll put the name here on the screen. I want to say it's lilac, but I'm not 100% sure. But I don't even know if you'd want to go purple, but purple is my favorite color. So I did the purples as well. First sentiment, you are simply amazing. Starfish wishes and seahorse kisses thinking of you. Look at them. Aren't they gorgeous? And then they cut out with the coordinating die. Super, super pretty. And I was trying to use up my purple tape. So I was glimmering with the purple tape. Please don't do what I did. I have paper fibers everywhere. Use your Spellbinders yellow tape when you're doing glimmer hot foil. Don't use purple tape. The purple tape heats up with the glimmer hot foil and then the adhesive, it started sticking on things where it shouldn't be sticking. That's my little sidebar tip. I'm only going to use it for die cutting. I am not going to use it for glimmering. I was trying to finish up on my original purple tape. Ugh. Yellow tape. Have my little bag. I was doing my factory mode. Super duper pretty. Up next, we have Under the Sea Hot Foil Plates. This is all marine life goodness. This has the cutouts. See how it cuts out? You're looking at 3 by 2.25. Okay, there is this one. Here's the jellyfish. There are the fish. If you're wondering where this one is, it's over here in my card example right there. Okay, so again, this is the satin metallics. This is that beautiful dark gold in that 4-pack. So love. Let me go get it. This is my satin metallics hot foil roll. That's the dark gold. See how pretty that is. Look at that. So, so pretty. I'm dying for Spellbinders to carry this one because there is a light gold to it as well. It's a 4-pack. I have a few of these 4-packs because this is a winning hot foil set. Just give it a try. If you are going to prep for the workshop, get yourself a pack of this so that when you do make something, you're just like, ooh la la. And also, another favorite, opaque black and white hot foil roll. There is the opaque black and white. You also just saw it in the sentiments here. Winner, winner, these two. I'm going to link those below as well so you can take a look and add it to your stash. But you are definitely seeing all this satin metallic goodness. So here is that Sea Life, and I did a collage on this one. Actually, this is all three. I was thinking of doing this, but you see how you can play? I could have also put this over here with the seahorse and do a whole thing. I was even thinking of going on the outside, but I decided not to. I restrained myself. Like normally I would have done something like this. I was thinking like that, which is kind of nice too, right? Are you getting ideas? If you're loving what I'm showing you, go for it. And you could scale it down to an A2. So you can glimmer without having to color. But on this one, I did color. I love to use for these type of things. They become delicate, especially when you die cut them. I love to use a 4-millimeter bag. So a standard Ziploc bag is like maybe 2-millimeter. It usually flops. This one, little bit thicker. Because it's thicker, it does have structure. I'll link this too in case you want to get it. This is a 3x3, 3-inch by 3-inch 4mm bag. I love these. Here they are. Let's just quickly go into it while I'm here. I'm jumping again. I'm so excited by all this goodness. We had hummingbirds. We have stylish ovals with beautiful florals and birds. And then now this under the sea goodness. Oh, this is just like too fabulous. So here you're looking at Bow Seahorse. This is called Seahorse Floral. I love the name, right? Seahorse Floral. Because there's a flower, seahorse. It's like a collage with this piece. 5¾, 3½. This is now me coloring, but you don't have to. It works both ways. Then there are some sentiments, which I also did in colors. See the opaque black and white? That's the black roll on white cardstock. There it is, thanks. I did purple. I even went into rainbow. Don't ask me why I did rainbow. I was just thinking under the sea with colors, but hey, there it is. And you do get some sentiments in this set. You get congrats with the coronating die that does cut in the inside of it, like that. And then you also get thanks. There's the thanks. And you also get this one with a label. This one is sending you an ocean of. And I did this in different colorways as well. Let me bring it up to you. This one I played more with matte gold hot foil roll. There's that same dark gold satin metallic. And then the rose gold satin metallic. You see the difference in the colors? Let me bring them up even closer so you can see what I'm talking about. Get yourself a packet of satin metallic. But the standard, like old, good, happy standard too, matte gold, matte silver. I've loved those too. But I still have like a rainbow of their colors anyway. But there's a some that just really lend themselves. Just like how we use black ink for stamping, like the standard. This baby, she hasn't been around for long, but boy, by far winner. And this too. These two. Fabulous, fabulous, fabulous. You can do sending an ocean of thanks, sending an ocean of congrats. About this one first, because this one includes all three sets. We have in the background, this is all that same hammer mill cardstock in the back and on the top. So it's like a bright white cardstock. Have my seahorse, and I cut this panel for the seahorse oversized because I had room to play when I wanted to do my frame. I did use a die to cut the frame out, and I used for the inside postage edge rectangles. Tell you, I'm loving this set. I hope a few of you got some of the postage edge with the BOGO sale last week. Right there. You see it? So I didn't get the dot detail, but I do have a second sheet of paper then with the dot detail on it. Once I use it like this, that inner piece I can use for something else. So it's sitting there waiting to be hot foiled. And then I measured 1 inch over the size. So this is 4¼. I went 5¼ by 5½, 6½. That's what you're seeing here for the frame. And then I just cut that with my trimmer after I die cut this. And then made that beautiful frame to house all of this foiled goodness. Once I had my floral seahorse in the background, then I left this open space, because you see all that open space, for the sentiment. Starfish wishes and seahorse kisses. Tongue twister. I've just said that like maybe 5 times before I could record it properly. And that's right here. So I left that open space to put that sentiment. This is popped up on 2 layers of 110-pound cardstock. See when you have the die? You get the excitement of popping it up. I could use foam, but no, I wanted to keep it a little bit lower than what is around here. Underneath here, I'm using scrapbook.com foam tape, the 1/4-inch roll, and also their 1/8 inch roll. So I'm keeping it more solid here because the 1/4-inch will go to about there. Then I still have a little bit of wiggle. So I did a whole bunch of surgery underneath this. But see how clean it looks? Could I have turned this into a shaker? Yes, but I did not want it to be a shaker. I wanted this to be a frame piece featuring loads of glimmer goodness. But yes, you could turn this into a shaker. Just put some acetate underneath that frame. Then I also popped up this. And that is the little fish with the shells and the wildlife. Isn't that pretty? And then here I use some, I'll put the name here. I can't remember what it's called. Glimmer drops, glitter drops, something like that. But it comes in gold, and the gold matches this dark gold. perfectly against that bright white. So this is me doing a elegant, clean card. Not easy for me doing clean cards, but I had to kind of restrain, because I wanted to pop this outside, and then I was like, no, keep it contained, keep it clean. But tell me below if you guys like my clean card. Recipients would love something like that. Next card, not so elegant, but still elegant in a different way. This is my tropical vacation card. I use this cardstock, which is a bright mint. I also used it before. If you watched my previous video, let me show you how it looks completely different two ways. Before, it was here with the hummingbird. That's it. And also here. It's a bright cardstock, but you use it in a bit. My bit is just the frame. Now, also from the BOGO sale, which I hope a few of you got, because I told you you're going to see it and you're going to be like, oh, yeah, it's so good. If not, then put it in your wish list and maybe next time around. Fluted Classic Rectangles comes out to a full A2 in the largest size. A2 is 4 1/4, 5 1/2. 3 pieces. Took out this piece, put it on the panel here, cut that out. Then took this beautiful cardstock and cut it out with this. I love the elegance of Fluted Classic in this application. I'm telling you, this little die set, fabulous. And I love this die set for clean cards. Let's take a trip down memory lane of clean cards. We're just over Easter. Remember these that I showed you? This is a clean way as well with the little bunny. But you see, Fluted Classic circles, Fluted Classic rectangles. Could this be on a smaller scale here with one of these? Oh, you bet. Let's just play. You guys know I like to play. I could go like so and then have a sentiment and be done. I might do that because that's really pretty, right? And this is just 2 die cuts and done. And then put this on the top. Take out my little pretty bunny. Love the little bunny. Hope you guys had a great Easter too. All right, let me pull this back out. So Fluted Classics, winner, winner. It's a great foundation to house this beautiful collage of Seahorse Kisses goodness. So the Seahorse floral, here it is. So when you glimmer it, it's going to do the reverse. I know it's facing that way, but once you put the plate over, it's the reverse, okay? I colored purposely 100% Olo markers. And with this one, I love a good swatch. I have my Copic swatch. I also have an Olo swatch. And what I did, I just looked at this and then picked out colors. Here, you're looking in this colorway. For the seahorse, for this shell, you're looking here. For the blues is a combination. This for the greenery, this for the florals, and then this one is right up here. And I love the name, coral, so I did the coral there. So you see what I did? I just looked at the chart and just picked a grouping, a grouping, a grouping, and some grouping, and then the green. I just got some greens the other day. I was curious. Yeah, I went and got the greens. I didn't really need to, but I was like, I want to get some of their greens. Because I'm liking how Olo, and this is where Olo is just topping Copics by a little bit. Because the Olos have more modern colors, and the modern colors are like calling me. They're like, Suzanne, yes, you can expand your color range. So this is an Olo chart, and Olo has, thank goodness, only 128 markers, so I don't have to start over, because Copics are 300 and something, and you get them double-sided, you know? So you're spending less money instead of on a full marker. And then I'm even getting fancy with it. This is the colorless blender. But I did all my Olo coloring, which is pretty easy. So what do you guys think? Super pretty, right? And are you loving this cardstock? I am loving this color. It's Basil Aruba. I will put a link for it too if you're liking this colorway for summer and that type of marine crafting, or with BB's hummingbirds. And I will put a link for all 6 collections within this release below in every single video. I tell you, this Seahorse Kisses, amazing. And you're seeing clean cards from me without tons and tons of effort, but boy, pow, right? Here, these gems, this is Pinkfresh Studio Aqua gems. The aqua is going so well with that Aruba. Notice the name Aruba Sea Life. So if you're going on your summer vacation, you're meeting up with folks, you want to make some great cards, or you come back from a trip and you want to do a bunch of thank you cards, this would be fabulous for that. Or if you have a friend and you want to make a box of cards for them, this is a fantastic gift to give someone. You could go small note cards, then you could go bigger in this, even on the A2. This is working A2, and it's also working a little bit oversized from A2. Don't forget the embossing folder. Expect to see something cute from me with that one too, because the embossing folder is amazing. All right, crafters, everything will be detailed and linked below for Seahorse Kisses Collection. Love, 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 love. Dawn, you did a good job, and ooh, the marine life is just coming to life. So fun, so elegant, so beautiful. Alrighty, crafters, until the next video. Stay crafty, my friends. Bye.